Hi, I'm Luke, and you're watching Photo Rehab. Here at Photo Rehab, we believe every photo should have another chance at being good because bad photos aren't born, they're made. For those that don't know, we live in an age where we can change any photo at the tip of our fingers. Our phones, computers, I guess that's it. But still, we use our fingers to change a photo. So any photo that you've rejected and chosen not to post can be made better and post-worthy. In this installment, we actually got so many of you to submit photos that we're gonna break this into two videos, just because I didn't want to make this go too long, and every photo story is important. Our first check-in for Photo Rehab was from Jacob. He submitted his beat me up picture. First of all, the cup made me chuckle, and I'm gonna be getting one as soon as this video is done. The beat me up picture had a rough past, and Jacob was concerned, so he brought him to rehab. This beat me up picture, we're gonna call it beat me up, before Jacob brought him willingly to rehab to make him a better picture. So we took the photo, we brightened it, we tried to kind of find what don't we like about this photo, what makes it bad, and then we dissect it and make it better. First, it's actually not that bad of a photo. I like it, it's very artsy. But the question came down to, is it in a coffee tin? Is that what it's in? So we kind of brightened it, it's a little noisy, so we blurred it. Some would say too much, I do not think so. The blur cleaned it up, we sharpened it a little bit just so it could stand out from the blur, the beam me up. At first, as with all rehabs, we pictured the perfect scenario of a picture with coffee beans and grounds just encompassing it within the coffee tin. But no. We upped it and we went the art factor. I did college for 4 years as a theater major, so dagnabbit, I'm gonna use my diploma for something. And for this photo, we're gonna be theatrical. What do you mean exactly? Well, we need to find the core, the script of this directorial debut of Beam Me Up. I can already tell my theatrical bit is going on too long, so we're just gonna move on. We flipped the image over, and what I really saw instantly, once we blended the two together, was that the cup handles formed a heart, and we love coffee. And that's what started to make this photo good. So now, subliminally, we see Beam Me Up, coffee cup, we see the coffee mug handles forming a heart, because who doesn't love coffee? And then we took the tin can edges and we basically just doubled and tripled it to expand out. So it's like inside of a machine mechanism. So deep down at the core of whatever's going on in life, we remember the love of coffee. And like that, we took Jacob's Beam Me Up picture and we made it better. Next submission we have from Thomas, and he actually posted this photo, so it's not a reject photo, but he was curious to see how we would rehab it to be better than it currently is. Let's find out. For the sake of this video, we'll call this photo Taxi. It's a good sight. You got the big city vibe. You have the taxi in the picture of you calling a taxi and everything around. Wanted to take the colors, make it pop a bit, make it stand out. Then we changed the color balance to bluish just to make it pop a little more, make it seem a little chilly because she is bundled up and let's face it, it's cold out right now. And then what we did, we cheated the system here in photo manipulation. We took the taxi and the car that was off in the distance, and I think what was missing in this picture, it was just too much in the picture for someone calling a taxi. So we moved the taxi closer to the person that they're about to get picked up. We brought the taxi over, we cropped it, because I really didn't want to remove the taxi from the other area, so we just cropped it so it's moved over. And then what we did was, I like the layered blur effect. It's cheap, it's got the iPhone portrait mode, which people like iPhone portraits, so people like blur. Let's face it. So what we did is we blurred the background, and then we blurred the second background with the background, so the background's blurrier, this one's not as blurry. And then we did a third, so you get layers of blurriness showing depth of field in the picture. I also blurred the front a little bit, so that way we're showing that the focus is directly on the person calling the taxi. So I cropped it in square for Instagram, just because more here at Photo Rehab, we do what works. We don't want to nickel and dime you, so we do what works, but we don't necessarily put in as much time as we should. Basically, if we were an actual rehab place, you would not want to send your loved ones here. But because it's photos, and photos don't have real feelings other than what we project onto them, we can stick with it. So anyways, we've taken Taxi, we've compressed it, we put it in the square and made it pop. And that's how you get Taxi 2.0. So Thomas, thanks for bringing your picture in. We're releasing it back to you with the wings to fly. This next submission is from Mary, or Marie, M-A-R-I-E, however you say it, I apologize. I don't know. Sent me this awesome picture of, I believe it's a peacock, sitting on a brick wall. It already is a cool shot. I can see why you took it. And this is why we bring in photos so we can make them better. My lawyers say we have to say this, but our photo rehab center is not licensed. So when you bring something here, we are not saying that we're professionals, but that we'd like to help in any way we can. So in this case, this is one instant where we took the photo, we started to improve it, and then we had an experimental idea that we wanted to try to make it even better. And just like in X-Men and Wolverine, we did that experiment and we made it a mutant. And it's a great mutant. a beautiful mute. We initially edited it, we popped it, we wanted to make the colors of the tail of the peacock pop, peacock pop, peacock pop, peacock pop. That's fun to say. We wanted to make the bricks pop and the sky pop blue, just because before it doesn't really capture the vibrance that we see in our human eye. So we went ahead, we did that, and then I was like, you know what, we need two peacocks, because if you have one peacock, you know there's another one around. We flipped the image, we doubled it, we made it look like it's sitting on like a brick well almost. This isn't perfection, but this is just to make the picture better. So we flipped it, we decided, hey, you know what, let's make the peacock a different color so it looks like they're like friends or partners or acquaintances. And it's not just like the picture flipped, even though it does. So your mind's like, this is flipped, but then you see the peacock's a different color, and you're like, oh, this is pretty cool. And then we even, because it's flipped, you see the house on one side, we use the clone stamp tool to put the bush over the house on the other side, so it doesn't look like an exactly flipped picture. The clouds, we admit, they do look a little more artish than the photo, but the goal is to rehab the photo, and that's what we did here. We call this one peacock, peacock. So thanks, Mary, all right. We release your, I used the wing analogy on the other picture. So now we gotta, you take your peacock and go home. Moving on. This submission we got from Ben, and what it is we're gonna call it Building in the Sky. And what it is, it's a building with the sky in the background. And it's actually, I like it. It's already centered. It's pretty focal point. I love the difference in the brightness in the top and the bottom. It's hard to capture the clouds in the sky. So what we did was I kind of just separated the sky with the buildings. I multiplied it a couple times, applied the multiply layer, and it allowed the actual clouds that were there to pop into place. A little darker, a little like stormy gloomy. In PA, it's always gloomy. Brighten the buildings to make it pop more, step away from the background of the dark sky. So I just blurred the buildings, again in layers. The closest one's the blurriest, and it gets less blurry, until you get to the focal point of, I believe, the church steeple thing. So I just quickly blurred it. Not everything was cut to precision like it normally would, but you brought us a photo. You brought us a photo into the rehab center, and we bring the picture back to you now for Building in the Sky. Even though technically it's not a building in the sky, it's Building in the Sky, but I already named it Building in the Sky. We can't change it. Changing pictures lives forever, one image at a time. All on, in full honesty, my computer was having issues screen recording and editing in Photoshop at the same time. So what I could have done with perfection, we kind of just went as is, so that way my computer didn't break. Here at Photo Rehab, we don't owe anyone explanations. Other than, who's that guy right there? That's me. I used to be an astronaut. Long story. Moving on, we got this one from Cameron. And ideally, what I wanted to do was he looked like a ballerina with, I think it's a dust ball. I just think of the what you see in the westerns where it's just blowing across the desert. What's it called? I don't know. Let me know in the comments below what it's called. Dust ball? I'm gonna call it that. Looked like a ballerina, but that was too obvious. Here, Cameron, we want you to get your money's worth, so we didn't want to go to the cliche ballerina pose. We wanted to make it something better. And what I wanted to do, make it look like you were coming out of the ground in this dust ball from the road. And as we started tweaking, I started doing it. My 9-month-old woke up, and here at Photo Rehab, unfortunately, babies take more priority than rehabilitating photos right now. Babies before JPEGs, right? That's not a thing. I love that you're saluting behind a dust bush, a dust ball, coming out of the road. This may not be perfection, but it's still a bad photo, made slightly not as bad. Finally, Julie submitted a picture of Mr. Basil, so I just need to legally say Mr. Basil was not submitted to rehab. Mr. Basil has been clean, as far as we know. The picture was submitted to a photo rehab. I call this one the Bunny Dream. Basically, I just cut him out. I smoothed him out and put him on top of a giant carrot that I found on unsplash.com. He's living the dream. He's riding it like a boat, eating it as he goes, going along life, singing, skipping, and laughing. That was a quick and fun one. I also added a shadow so it looked like he was standing there. And again, we brought in a photo and made it better, because bad photos aren't born, they're made. I'm gonna keep saying that a billion times. If you enjoyed, feel free to click the like button and subscribe button. And if you wanna get involved, follow me on Twitter @BrainChunks and send me a picture for me to use in another episode. I'll be making part two, and I'll link to that video here once it's made, but right now we're focusing on this one till it's done. So have a great day. Take care of those bad photos, because they're gonna be good photos.